A few episodes ago, I did the top 10 animated music videos, and someone requested this video, the top 10 expensive music videos. Yeah, Black Queen requested this video. He really wanted me to do this. He said to me, well, since you're doing music videos, you can react to this video as well, so we're gonna do that today. Do I have some predictions? I don't know. Are Tool videos expensive? Not sure, but they look pretty well done, so I'm expecting a Tool video on there. I believe that a Guns N' Roses video is gonna be on there, one of the trilogy videos from the Illusion Records, Estranged, Don't Cry, and November Rain. So I'm guessing November Rain or Estranged. Don't Cry was a bit cheap from what I saw, but there we are. So I believe one of those two songs is gonna make the list. Something else, yeah, Mariah Carey's on the thumbnail, so I think, I believe that song is called Glitter, but I really lost interest in her when she turned into the new millennium, when she lip-synced a lot and, well, made that Glitter record, which was not her best album, to say the least. So, yeah. Those are some music videos that are gonna make the list. Yeah, I don't have a lot of predictions because I don't watch a lot of music videos, but we're just gonna see what's on the list, so let's go. George Michael.
First, video killed the radio star, and then it went and robbed the bank as well.
A horrible joke.
Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today,
we'll as usual, watch Mojo.
Our picks for the top 10 insanely expensive music videos. For this list, we've looked
really
at the
ugly
budget music videos. Although all of today's entries are incredibly costly, today's countdown is not purely a statistical list of those that cost the most.
That Thriller looks pretty expensive because it also is a bit of a short film. I believe it is half an hour long if you look at the music video. So, well, to have that length and all that effort put into it, you can have a pretty expensive music video. So I think that is going to be on there as well. How could I not think of one of the first music videos ever? What the fuck is this?
Number 10. Cartoon Heroes, Aqua.
We are what we're supposed to be.
Oh, horrible vocals. I believe Aqua is that one fucking group that had Barbie Girl or something. That Watch Mojo, don't fucking play that piece of shit. I fucking dare you. Yeah, Aqua is just a bit of a dated band. Just a bit. They're really dated. Yeah, they only have one song that they made fun of. And, well, that is their... their most popular song, ironic enough. Yeah, and they didn't really survive the 90s, so turning into the new millennium, Aqua wasn't really well known, and this was probably their last claim to fame or something like that. But yeah, the song sounds horrible, the vocals are horrible, and yeah, Aqua is just a fucking horrible band. Not the worst band ever. I've heard worse and worse, but they're way up there.
Euro disco pop simply doesn't get any better than this, or more expensive. Cartoon Heroes was released only a month
no comment
the current millennium as Aqua's first record for over 14 months, and after
who
the
cares
of Barbie Girl.
I say don't play this shit, they fucking play it. Fuck you, Watch Mojo.
Though it never hit the heady heights of its predecessor, it did perfectly sum up what Aqua were all about: clean, catchy, comic-inspired fun.
Yeah, but Barbie Girl's garbage as well, so fuck off. I mean, I hate Barbie Girl, don't get me wrong, but that song was at least a sort of catchy, and it was just a bit of not a guilty pleasure for me, but because I think it's shit, but it is kind of ironic, or it is kind of, just a guilty pleasure for others to enjoy when they are drunk as shit or something like that. It is a song like that. That is what is Aqua all is going to be remembered for. That is a bit sad, but hey, That is all the longevity and all the talent they have, so there we are. And yeah, they didn't really survive that song after that, and this song just sounds all over the place, man. It is horrible.
$3 million video certainly captured attention. It took us to outer space, underwater.
I'm wondering where that money is coming from.
Everywhere in between.
From their only fucking hit.
What they do really is what we wish to do.
I mean, how can this shit look like $3 million to you? It's just horrible.
Number 9, Larger Than Life, Backstreet Boys. From the very beginning, there's a giant spaceship passing.
I don't know if I really hate this song, because I think the Backstreet Boys are the only alright boy band, if that is a thing. Yeah, most people are gonna say that all boy bands are fucking garbage, but I think this is one of the few exceptions, so they are alright, but I wouldn't listen to them on a regular basis. But I don't think they're shit or something, you know? But this video looks really fucking cheesy as all their videos, so
Star Wars, while playing
every boy band video ever.
Boys back catalog, it's clear that the next 4 minutes are gonna be boy band epic. And for $2.1 million, it certainly should be.
I have one question though. If this one is $2.1 million dollars, then why is Aqua's video lower? Because that one was $3 million. Am I missing something, or doesn't add up? I'm just asking.
Larger Than Life was released as the second single from the band's Millennium
album. I mean, how do you fuck up don't say shit that you can't pronounce. Fucking hell. Statistics. Something like that.
As the five band members each find themselves in out of this world situations, we're left.
You know, how do you fuck up numbers like that? I'm just gonna say that. I'm not gonna try. Statistics, something like that. Mariah Carey.
Number 8, Heartbreaker, Mariah Carey featuring Jay-Z. The cheating boyfriend in our next song breaks hearts, but the video accompaniment breaks the bank.
But how? They're just dancing.
Over $2.5 million.
How? They're moving this as a fucking movie. Fucking hell. They're filming this at the fucking movies. How can it be $2.5 million?
It's part of a plot in which Mariah's boyfriend, for some unimaginable reason, tries to two-time the legendary pop star. There are dancing ushers and animated sections, but the Mariah on Mariah Ladies Bathroom Showdown has to be the highlight.
Yeah, but how is it so expensive?
It's set in the movie theater, it's worthy of Hollywood itself.
No comments.
Number 7. MC Hammer featuring Saja.
I fucking hate MC Hammer. I'm really asking where he got the money from. Yeah, from the only fucking hit song.
This is one of the most expensive music videos ever. It's also one
but how it looks horrible.
And one of the least well remembered.
You cannot believe everything that you read in the tabloids, okay?
It's packed full of famous faces though, including John Belushi, Henry Winkler, Queen Latifah, and James Brown.
Oh, that's kind of sad.
A levitating Mr. Hammer, a whole load of pyrotechnics, and the glitter.
Horrible. Those fucking special effects, man. When you look at that, it looks like it's just $1,000, but it's like $2 million. That's really
Michael
sad.
Jackson.
Really. You have so many cameos in your music video, and it is so shit and so dated and so not well remembered. So forgettable. So, yeah, waste of money. Waste of money and time.
But yet it's still regularly remembered as one of the worst music videos of the 1990s. You just can't pay for popularity.
Horrible. The fuck is this?
Number 6. It's all coming back to me now.
Oh, Celine Dion.
Celine Dion. There were
nights when the wind was... Yeah, that's alright. I mean, of course, those pop stars like Mariah Carey and Celine Dion have a shitload of money because they are pop stars, but hey, they're beer.
Originally recorded by girl group Pandora's Box.
That sounds alright.
It's All Coming Back to Me Now was made most famous by...
Also sounds alright. Yeah, but Celine Dion's version sounds the most powerful.
The $2.3 million video is filmed mostly in the summer palace of the Austrian Emperor, and the clip's moody atmosphere is the epitome of gothic grandeur. But you are history with the slamming of the door. It's forever compared to the video for another Steinman number, Bonnie Tyler's Total Eclipse of the Heart,
oh,
but
no.
The latter costs substantially less to make.
Don't get me wrong, decent song, but one of the most horrible music videos ever made. Horrible.
Number 5, Victory. Puff Daddy featuring the notorious
A rap shit.
Busta Rhymes. Yo, the sun don't shine
forever, but as long as it's... I mean, I'm not the biggest fan of Biggie Smalls and that other guy that was mentioned, but Puff Daddy is fucking horrible though. Don't get me wrong, he can produce, he has a shitload of money, but don't open your mouth, please.
And as well shine together. Dennis Hopper and Danny DeVito both feature in our next video, which sees Puff Daddy at the height of his powers and the notorious B.I.G. brought back to life. Rapper stars posthumously in Victory, which also features a feather-clad Busta Rhymes spitting lyrics from the shoulders of statues. In general, there's a very ominous feel about this clip, which is all heavy rain and raging fire. And the grisly, ghostly, gloomy effect didn't come cheap, with production costs running beyond $2.7 million.
Estranged.
Number 4, Estranged. Guns N' Roses. Directed by...
Yeah, I thought November Rain or Estranged, but Estranged is, I believe, a bit longer and it looks more expensive, so yeah. I think those two come really close, but hey, it is Estranged, so there we are. Good music video, by the way.
Beforehand, the video for Estranged is the third installment to a Guns N' Roses trilogy.
Yeah, and Don't Cry is the worst. November Rain and Estranged come pretty close though, so choose for yourself.
Don't Cry and November Rain preceding it. Just like the previous two, it's an epic, all-encompassing narrative with Axl Rose at its core and Slash taking center stage for some particularly incredible scenes.
Yeah, the solo is pretty good.
Rock and roll than shredding your guitar while walking on water.
Slash is just saying, I'm Jesus. Or that was Axl's idea, but there we are.
$4 million video.
It's kind of nice if you think about it. Kind of nice.
Drained almost as much as the production team's finances.
Black and white.
Three,
black or white.
Michael Jackson.
That would be really crazy if you're black and white.
Jackson made a habit of making big budget music videos. The videos for both Thriller and Bad were the most expensive ever seen at the time of their release. But Jacko's costliest video as a solo performer accompanies the 1991 single Black or White.
I actually thought that Thriller was going to be on the list, but hey, it is Black or White, so...
Costing $4 million and directed by John Landis, who also took the chair for Thriller, it sees the moonwalking pop icon dance his way across the planet, aided by classic-era Macaulay Culkin. Clocking in at 11 minutes, the video has the rare distinction of debuting simultaneously to a global audience of 500 million people across 27 different countries.
Please don't say it, it's Madonna. Please don't say it. Please. Fuck.
By another day, Madonna.
Oh, that autotune, yes, yes.
Another icon and another star consistently rewriting the record books for music video expense. 1995's Bedtime Story and 1989's Express Yourself both smashed spending records when they were released, but the video for the 2002 James Bond theme, Die Another Day, almost cost more than the other two combined.
Madonna is so bad.
It's an entirely original Madonna clip, though the influence of Bond is clear. Another example of seeing double as the singer does battle with herself. With a 6.1
yeah, just fucking die.
Tag, there has only ever been one music video more expensive. And another example of seeing double as the singer does battle with herself. With a $6.1 million price tag, there has only ever been one music video more expensive than this. Before we unveil our top pick, here are a few honorable mentions.
What is it gonna be? Busta Rhymes featuring Janet Jackson. It looks horrible. Miami from Will Smith, when he had a rap career. Freak from George Michael. Doesn't look the most expensive, but well, it has some pretty crazy special effects back in the day, so I guess it is the most expensive, but it is a bit dated by today's standards now. But yeah, that is one feat that's, well, it is difficult to accomplish. You just have to be really fucking rich to do that, but yeah, the Germany number one, well, it is a fact, so you can't really argue with it.
So, do you agree with our list? Which costly clip did we miss?
Can't really agree because it is a facts list. There we are.
For more outrageously expensive top 10s published daily, be sure to subscribe to WatchMojo.com. What you gotta be for me?
Yeah, that was alright. Thank you, Black Queen, for requesting this list. Yeah, let's go to the comments a bit. Now do one of the top 10 cheapest music videos ever. Yeah, and I guess... How's the one, David Hasselhoff is gonna be on the list, but that one music video that was really fucking shitty. Yeah, one guy sharing statistic. There we are, statistics. Yes, I can say the word now, statistics. Finally, fucking Lee, after 15 minutes or something. More comments. Fun fact, Michael Jackson's Scream was actually shot in outer space. Superman was the director, that's why it was that expensive. I'm not sure, but... yeah, whatever. Celine Dion. Yeah, how to say it? It has 700 likes, go figure. Yeah, but that is how much Mojo says it, so yeah, fuck off. It is Celine Dion, not Celine Dion. But hey, there we are. Which Mojo really likes to talk with an accent in their music, or in the music videos, in their top 10 list as well, in every video they make. Leave it up to Michael Jackson to make this list twice, that is certainly true. That is how much of a legend he is. But yeah, the comments aren't really interesting, so yeah, I hope you've enjoyed the video. Like this video, subscribe to this channel to support this channel. So I hope you've enjoyed it, do all the things you just said, and enjoy.